Well, folks, I want to dedicate this vlog to dear friends from Holland, Henk and Trudy. And sadly, last week, Henk lost his battle and sadly died in Trudy's presence. So there's Henk with his old faithful dog, Jimi Hendrix. So this one's for you, Henk.
Now there she is, look, put straight up, aren't you? Aren't you? Just look at you. Yes, yes, there she is, and oh, thank you, Minnie, thank you. Thank you, you're such a lovely, oh, and the other foot. Mum's taught her well. Right, well, here's Rosie. I'm going to take her down to the pond. And here's Minnie. She's just been having a kip in a little kennel, haven't you? Here she is. Look, look. There she is. She likes to put her leg up. Hello. Hello, Minnie. Lovely dog. Yes. She's a favourite by many. Right, come on, Rosie. Yeah. Rosie.
Come on.
So we've got Bobby here, we've got Ash, and I tell you what, Ash is getting quite a size now. So right, let's have a walk over the other side, take these two over, and then come back and get ready. And been a bit of rain this week so far. Not that I've had chance to do out vloggy wise like, but the old pond's up, and I got stuck with bloody fish and that. I think I previously mentioned I caught one the other day. I just come down with a little fishing rod, now it's spectacular like. First catch in with a bit of bread paste on, boom. One of them oily catfish, good size. About 14 inches, 16 inches, maybe more, I don't know. But yeah. Yeah, little bit overcast, which is bloody good. But right, oh, I better get the key to open the gate. And I'm not doing it. Needs a bit cutting. Needs a bit grass cutting. On the bridge as well, like bloody hell. You can see a bit of water still flowing through like, so yeah. Good. Now when I can get Bobby off the road, the old foot sailing a bit, I'm a bit more mobile. We'll better get on to doing some jobs, but no bush cutting, Michael. No machines. Well, certain machines and that, but bush cutters, no. Leave them. They have a lethal bloody reputation anywhere, and it's the second time I've had experience of that, and they are. Right, gate.
Now, here's Bobby. Patient, Bobby. Keen.
Hey, don't knock the bloody gate off, it's injured. Hey. Hold on, hold on. There they go. There they go. And away they go. All them plants we got a couple of weeks ago, they're all in. Mem's got them all in. 286 or 70, 78, whatever. She's got them in. Right. I'll get up the top end and I'll resume. Look at the expanse of water in there, like some fish in there and all. Yeah, there'll be fish all over the bloody place. But also frogs, toads. Down in the pool, not so many. Not so many frogs, froglets, tadpoles. Them days are gone. Why's that, Michael? Been eaten, haven't they? The old pla fish. So yeah, over here in there, though there's a good 150 plants gone in there. But they're looking well, they're looking well. Said, what's that? What is it? What's there? I don't want to go piling in with a bloody snake. Oh, what is it? What's there, Bobby? Lizard. Lizard. Hey. She's as big as Bobby, if not slightly bigger. No, Maurice, she's not far off. What is it, Bobby? Huh? What is it, why, Bobby? He's looking a lot better, a bit more beefy. Mem's feeding him a bit extra. Instead of getting fed just on a tea time. No, they're... Oh, don't go piling in that mud. Oh, Mama Mem are gone deaf. Now, you see, Mem's been at bloody work. Look, all them bloody old banana trees and that. They're down. Good. Give space for these government trees to get up. And they're coming on nicely. Coming on nicely. So, who have we got now, Michael? Well, Bobby's gone for a rest. So we've got Brady Boy and Rosie, and once again, Ash. Ash is getting a bit of air in today, is Ash? Not so much the house dog today. Right, come on. Ready. Hey? Now, Brady. Now, keep an eye on Rosie. Let her have a bit run about her, not, but keep an eye on her. A lot of smelling going on. In fact, I think she's wanting, Rosie's wanting to mount Ash. She's not far off, is Rosie. The blood stopped at the moment. So, but Mem has it all worked out, the days and when she's due to conceive and all this, like. It's just these bloody oily catfish. Big gobs on them, like me. So.
And here we have a village lady looking after her two buffaloes. And they're munching away on a bit of, I don't know what type of grass that is, but they seem happy, they're wagging their tails, so, dee dee. Well, we're out today, been to the big city to buy some new aircon. And on the way back, we called in at Mem's mother's, and she wanted us to drop some stuff off at a WAT that she's associated with. I think she's associated with about bloody 600. Now there you are. There's the best quality Thai ladders. Even these engineers that come and fix your, put your broadband in and that, you don't see them with top quality aluminium ladders. You see them with these, bamboo. So here we are. It's fairly new, this WAT. So Michael's gonna have to take his shoes off. So the old she's given Mem some stuff for the monk. There's only one monk lives here, that's all. And through donations and this, that and the other, they've built this WAT on water. Obviously it's made of concrete, so pretty solid. And then you get in, it's now flush. And here we have the old Buddhist gong, which you usually ring in respect of people that's passed, or just wishing good luck to people and that, like. So now, no doubt, there'll be some fish in there, I would think. And look at that tree there. Now, Mem's got a lot of them trees over the other side, so that gives you an indication of what size they grow to. And there'll be some money in that. And you can see the power supply coming in. It looks a bit burnt there, but cool. Don't ever say safety first in Thailand. Just doesn't exist. But there you go. And over there he's got a stock of water. There's only him here. That's all. And again, it's not a village WAT. It's again what they call a jungle WAT. So, what creepy crawl is this about in there, Michael? God knows. I wouldn't like to find out.
Well, what's going on today, Michael? Well, we've got our good friend the aircon man here, and he's started to fit a new aircon for us, because the old LG after nearly 4 years of work. The compressor's all right, but it's the bloody unit inside. The fan's worn out and it's not working properly. So we've had to invest in a new one. So we've gone Chinese, and we've got for this here, or whatever they call it, to give it a go. To tell you the truth, this LG cost us over 15,000, and it was virtually 50% off 4 years ago, and we bought that at Home Pro in the Pattaya when we were down at the condo, and it's had some bloody hard graft to do, but he says it's repairable, so he's gonna repair it, gonna get it repaired, and it's going in along there, hopefully. See what the repair bill is. But this here, to tell you the truth, the big one over the other side there, that cost us over 30,000, but it's quite a big one. The LG was 12 BTUs, what the term for the room size, and this is equivalent 12. Now, we got this for 9,900, and we got another 1,000 knocked off discount. Where do you get this, Michael? Well, you can buy things online at Lazada, but you take a risk with warranty. We bought this at one of the top stores in Thailand called Thai Wazadu. So we've got a bit of a guarantee with it. So let's see how this one operates. At that sort of price, you can't bloody fall up. 8,900 for a new aircon system. This fella, he took the old one out, replaced it with all new stuff and that, and charges 1,500. So not bad, not expensive. I know you can pay 500 for the service, but there's a lot more involved into doing a complete refit, like. So yeah, let's see how this one works out. So there you go. Major problems with aircon. Watch where you get them and watch what you're buying. We'll be right back.
Thank you.